Hi, it's Phil from Delphi Technologies. In today's video, we're going to show you how to bed the brakes in correctly on a Tesla Model S. Now, Tesla actually put a specific routine in the vehicle to bed the brakes in correctly, and it just stops any noise, vibration, or harshness. Let's jump in the car, pull it into calibration mode, and let's do it on the road. So now we're in the car and we found a suitable place to stop. We need to do three things to put this car to prepare to bed the brakes in. So step one, we need to put the car into service mode. We're going to press software, hold down the car, get the pulse, and then we're going to type in the word service. This allows us to put the car into service mode, ready to bed the brakes in. So step one, put the car into service mode. Step two, we need to disable the speed limiter. So when the service mode screen loads up, we're going to go into settings, into service settings, and we're going to override the speed limiter there, just because during this test, we're going to need to be accelerating a little bit quicker than the speed limiter will allow. Step three, we need to enable brake burnishing. And once we go through the warning, so we've got two options, start guided process or disable regen. We're going to use the start guided process. Now you can see, as I put my foot on the brake pedal, you can see the pressure reading there in bar. And what we've got to do is during the process, we've got to increase speed to 46 mile an hour. We're going to hit the brakes till about that level of brake pressure. It will give us a guide in the next screen. And then we're going to have to slow the vehicle down until we hear the chime. So let's go ahead and see what that looks like. So we can see now we're going to accelerate to 46 miles an hour. We're going to put my foot on the brake pedal between 20 and 40 bar, hold the brake pressure in that position until we slow down. Then we're going to give a 25 second cool down on the brakes, and then we're going to run that cycle again. And basically we're going to do that 10 times. Now the reason for doing this is we want to bed the new pad onto the disc. But what we don't want to do is, while it's getting warm, is we don't want any of the pad material to transfer onto the brake disc. That will give us high spots and low spots, and it will cause disc thickness variation. And ultimately the customer is going to notice excessive judder from the brake pedal. So let's go ahead and start, and I'll show you what it looks like. We can now go into drive. Now you're going to find a suitable road for this. Obviously making sure that you're adhering to all of the speed limits and the laws. So we're going to accelerate to 46 miles an hour. Make sure we've got a nice clear part on the road. 46 miles an hour. We hear the chime, we're going to brake. You see the target, and then let go. We're going to have a 25 second cool down period now, where we're going to let the pads and the discs cool down just that little bit, and then we're going to run that procedure again. So let's fast forward, let's jump onto the next cycle. Right, brakes have cooled down, we're going to be in the second cycle, up to 46 miles an hour, and brake, hit that target pressure, and there we go. So that's the second one completed. Once the cool down is finished, that will give us a count on number two. Now we simply do that 10 times, and what we're going to do now is fast forward to the end once we've completed it 10 times and just show you what the end screen looks like. So as you can see, we've now done the 10 cycles, the brake bedding in procedure is correct, and doing this correct procedure is going to help reduce vibration and any noise and squealing from those brakes. So thanks for watching, and if you want to see more vids, then why not follow us on social media or visit the Masters of Motion online hub. And for more expert-led courses, visit us online at the Delphi Technologies Academy. Thanks for watching.